Hello guys, welcome back to your Netcode-Hub channel. In the previous video, we talked about filter components. And we talked about how to perform the menu filter type, the filter bar, Excel alike, and also the checkbox. So we had a look on this, and we're able to actually go through this. This is what we're going to talk about, a search page. You want to have a search page here where you can actually search through the entire page or the entire data grid. In the filtering, you can see that we had text boxes beneath each of these header. And you can search that corresponding to what that is the data beneath. But you can't search first name at the email column. You can't search last name at the first name column. So that is a section being specified or being specific to the column header. You want to have a general search bar. If a person email, it must work. Last name, it must work. First name, it must work. ID, it should work also. So that's what we're going to take a look in this video. Without much ado, let's get right into business. This is the first thing to do. So let's first clear. There is. So currently we don't need all this. Let's take off this. The filtering. So now we are not doing any filtering. Now let's take off the allow filtering also. So what you're going to do here is, in our note, we first have to declare this value on top. And now this value is supposed to be a test. So let's see. So in here we have an else statement. So let's specify the value straight ahead. Let's copy only this. Val search tool is equal to a new list of string than a search. This search test. So let's pass it here. Now with this search tool, let's copy this. And now in between the SF grid, let's specify toolbar. Equal to let's pass in the search tool, this search tool. That is what we have here. Let's save this. Let's close this gap. Let's save this. Let's refresh our page and see. So our page is now loaded, and I can see that we have a search tool over here. And this search text, let's pass in ID1. So we can just click on enter. We have ID1. Let's search ID5. Click on enter or click on this any of the page to set this text box as unfocus, and you're gonna have that search. So let's see, click on the search icon and you have ID5. If it is John, you have John here. Okay, now if it is email, let's copy this email. Let's paste it here, hit on the enter, you have the email. What if you want to exclude a specific column from being searched? Let's say email. You don't want email to be searched. How are you going to do it? That is also a very simple thing to do. So in order to do that, to exclude, this is what you want to do. To exclude the following, you have to set allow searching, we set it to false. And we are good to go. So let's say, now in our page, and we have ID, we have email. So let's set email, or let's set this, the ID, as allow searching. Let's set this to false. Let's save this. Save this. Let's refresh our code. So let's try to paste the email that we, okay, so you see it's still working. Now let's pass in the ID, ID5, no record to display, ID1, it's not found, right? But if you pass in John, we have it. Okay, so that is it for the search. I believe this is clear. Now I always say that with the sync fishing data grid, adding all these components or these features, they are very easy. Maybe just two codes, one, and you're good to go. Because when using normal HTML or any other language or component, it's going to have to work a lot to get this. But I can see with the sync fusion, small one, and then boom, you're done. Alright, so that is it for this video. I always encourage you to use the sync fusion component, and it's very helpful. It's very nice as well. Alright, so I'll catch you up in the next video to discuss the next one. Thank you guys for watching. Let's go out for a break.